This is my favorite pose in yoga. Don't get me wrong, I mean, I like sun salutation. Kind of like triangle pose. I love candlestick pose and then going into plow. But this, you know, corpse pose. Extraordinary. And it's hard. It's not easy. I mean, it looks like I'm doing nothing. And it's a little weird because, like you might think corpse pose would really be here. But this is not very relaxing. I mean, if I were to ask you all to lie down right now, none of you would make this pose. Like, if I said, please lie down in a comfortable position, you wouldn't do this. I mean, maybe it should be called sunbathing pose, because that's sort of more what it's like. But corpse pose is probably, I mean, some people say it's the most important pose, but people don't do it all that often, you know, teachers. I mean, they do, but they don't do it long enough. I mean, it's supposed to be when everything gets integrated, everything that you've done, all the poses, the breathing, the pranayama. This is when it gets to be integrated. You know, which I guess is what death is, right? Corpse pose. It's when everything gets integrated. Your whole life, your life flashes before your eyes before you die. Is that the integration process? Was it a fear process? And I can never remember the Sanskrit name. It's either Shavasana or Savasana or Shavasana, I think. Corpse pose. And the mind is supposed to, you know, get quiet in corpse pose. That's the hard part. And, you know, sometimes people will play music during that. You know, these days there's this thing of like doing this sort of disco Buddha music in yoga. You know, it's like this boom, chik, boom, chik, boom, chik, and lift your arms up and take a breath in and just feel the air as you go through into boom, chik, boom. I don't like it. I want the silence. But in corpse pose, I like sometimes having a background noise to help quiet stuff down. You know, like a white noise. So if you wouldn't mind just making a little white noise, that would be great. Nice. Yeah. And feel free to breathe. I mean, you know, you got to. Yeah, but like laughing, that's not a part of white noise. Right? That's like standing out. The thing with white noise, it's like brown, you know, brown suits? That kind of stands out. Like gray suits, black suits, blue suits. That's white noise. Brown suits? A pink suit? Nobody wears those. Like, that's standing out. Fit in, please. Normally, when I'm in Shavasana, corpse pose, I just notice what's going on in my body. Like right now, I'm noticing that my right hip is tight. Thank you, Mr. Arthritis. And my left hip is like... My mouth is a little dry. And my left shoulder hurts. And my neck is a little tweaky. Actually, I lied, it's not my left shoulder, it's my right shoulder. Is that a lie? I just got confused. Yeah, there's a lot you can think about in corpse pose. You can think about the person who farted next to you. The lady who always snores in the back corner. You can think about how your marriage is falling apart, how your kids are falling apart, how the world is falling apart. You can think about life, you can think about death, you can think about those emails you have to answer, you can think about, this is lasting too long. You can think about how you've asked the teacher to do that favorite pose and they haven't done it, they didn't do it last week, they didn't do it this week. And can you ask again? And is that getting a little pushy and demanding? But I pay for this class, so why can't I do that? But I need to be a kind and compassionate person, but I want to get what I want, so what's wrong with that? You can think about the guy over there that you have a crush on. You can think about, why did I wear these pants? They make my ass look horrible. You can think about the tension in your eyes. You can think about, did I turn the soup off? There's a famous acting teacher. He was married to Stella Adler. I keep thinking her name is Bella Abzug, but it wasn't Bella Abzug. Stella Adler, and his name was Lee Strasberg. And so, in class one day, apparently a woman is on stage, and she's doing her thing, whatever she's doing in her scene, and he stops the showing and says, what's your foot doing? What does your foot want to say? Thinking that there's a lot of information in that that's not getting out. So, what does my calf want to be telling me? Sometimes I think about my blood coursing through my body. You know, you have 60,000 miles, like a child has around 60,000 miles of veins, capillaries, and arteries, an adult, almost 100,000 miles of these tunnels in your body. And your heart can pump that blood through, all that blood, through those 100,000 miles of tunnels. In 1 minute, it gets all your blood through all of those. 100,000 miles. So since we've been together, your blood has traveled about 800,000 miles. That's like 40 times around the planet Earth. Aren't you tired? Okay, so I lied just a little bit. It's not that one drop of blood goes all the way through all 60,000 miles and like back at the toe. It started at the toe and goes through everything and back, because if it was going that fast, the blood would literally rip out of your body because it's going so fast. No, it's that the blood goes from like your toe up and then back down. It doesn't always go to the same place. But all your blood goes through your heart in 1 minute, from all 60,000 miles, all the corners of it, to another place. And again, I don't think that was a lie. That was it wasn't misinformation like my shoulder. It was, well, my mother used to say, I'm not lying, I'm exaggerating. And just so you know, I've lied 5 times since we've been together. And I'm gonna lie about 82 more times. And sometimes I'll let you know when I've lied, and sometimes I won't. Can I get some white noise, please? When I die, I want to be thrown in the woods. Like, I don't need to be put in a box and buried. I'd rather just have some animal eat me and turn into a tree or something at some point. I asked my friend Michelle how she wanted to be buried. We were on a road trip in Mexico in my car. I was traveling with her. She was in my dance company, and we had gone through almost all of Mexico. Yeah. And she had said, doesn't matter to me how I die, or not how I die, doesn't matter to me how I'm buried, I just don't want to be buried next to my uncle. Her family had a plot, and I don't know why I asked her how she wanted to be buried. I didn't know we were going to get in a car accident. But maybe I did. Maybe I knew that she was going to die. Or maybe she knew, and somehow she transferred that over to me. I mean, was it just happenstance that I asked her? Was I being curious? Was I being a provocateur the way my mother is a provocateur?
So I start out at the toe, and I move along a little bit. I come up to the knee, and then here we go. Hey, testicles, how are you doing today? On up to the heart. I've got about 30 more seconds in which to get some oxygen. I'm going to come up here to the head, hang out in the brain, do a little bit of stuff in the brain. And then, hey, the eyeballs. Let's look at the eyes. What is he looking at now? Really? You're lying here. Lying here. How long have you been lying here? I'm sorry. I just need to apologize for the 3 billion cells that make up this lump of, you know, pretentious matter that thinks he can just lie here while you're watching. You know, one time he got a bumper sticker from his sister that said, just because they don't understand you, doesn't mean you're an artist. Clearly, he doesn't remember that bumper sticker. I mean, what are you? You're not saying anything new. And whatever you're not saying it in a very artistic way. What a nincompoop. You want some art? You want some good art? I'll show you some good art. All the world's a stage, and all the men and women are players. They have their exits and their entrances, and one man in his time plays many parts, his acts being seven ages. At first, the infant, mewling and puking in the nurse's arms, and then the whining schoolboy, with satchel in hand and shining morning face, creeping like snail, unwillingly, to school. And then, the lover, sighing like a furnace with a woeful ballad made to his mistress's eyebrow. Then the soldier, full of strange oaths, bearded like the pard, jealous and honored, sudden and quick in quarrel, seeking the bubble reputation. Even in the cannon's mouth. Then the justice, in fair round belly, good caping line, eye severe, beard of formal cut, full of wise saws and modern instances. The sixth age slips into the silvered and slippered pantaloon with spectacles on nose and pouch on side, his youthful hose well saved, a world too wide for his shrunk shank, and his big manly voice turning again towards childish trouble, pipes and whistles in its sound. The last scene that ends this strange, eventful history is second childishness and mere oblivion. Sans teeth. Sans eyes. Sans taste. Sans everything. And now for a slightly different version. All the world's a stage, and all the men and women merely players. They have their exit stage right, and their entrances stage left. And each man in his time plays seven parts. The first, the infant. Mewling and puking in his nurse's arms. The second, whining schoolboy, with satchel in hand and shining morning face, bang on. Creeping like snail, unwillingly to school.
And then the lover. Lover.
Lover.
Sighing like a furnace
with a woeful ballad made to his mistress's eyebrow.
Then the soldier, full of strange oaths and bearded like the pard, jealous in honor, sudden and quick in quarrel. Taxi! Seeking the bubble reputation, even in the cannon's mouth.
Then the justice, in fair round belly, good caping lined, with eyes severe and beard of formal cut, full of wise saws and modern instances. And so he plays his part. The sixth age shifts into the lean and slippered pantaloon, with spectacles on nose and pouch on side, his youthful hose well saved. A world too wide for his shrunk shank, and his big manly voice turning again towards childish treble pipes and whistles in its sound. Last scene of all that in this strange and uneventful history is second childhood and mere oblivion. Hey, Dad. How are you feeling today? Sans teeth. Sans eyes. Sans taste. Sans everything. And now for an interpretive dance version.
Not
Cue white noise.